Okay, the bottom line is these blood ketone strips are expensive and we don't want to be wasting them. There are several times during the day when testing will give you misleading readings. By the end of this video, you're going to know when you should be testing, when you shouldn't be testing, and how often you need to be testing in order to get an accurate picture of your ketone levels. Let's get started. Hey Carb Dodgers, my name is Dr. Dan Maggs. Thanks for visiting my channel where I help people achieve long-term sustainable weight loss through low-carb real food nutrition. I struggled with my weight pretty much my entire life until about 2016 when I went from officially obese to a normal weight in just over 6 months and I've maintained it ever since. And I'd love to show you how to do the same. I release new videos here every Tuesday and I'd love it if you'd subscribe to my channel and hit that bell to get notified whenever I release a new video. Now, I've never been a big tester of ketone levels, and when I went through my period of rapid weight loss back in 2016, I didn't actually check ketones once. I didn't need to because I was consistently losing weight and ultimately that was the goal. And there seems to be this myth in the keto diet world that we should be aiming for really, really high ketone levels all the time. And it's simply not true. In fact, I think it often leads to an overconsumption of fat and often an underconsumption of protein. And I've made a separate video that deconstructs this myth about high ketone levels. And you can check that out by clicking up here. It's also linked down below in the description below this video. Now, a lot of keto websites or YouTube channels are sponsored by the manufacturers of ketone meters. I'm not. So I'm not going to tell you that you should be testing all the time because it's simply not true. But testing does have its place and it can be useful, particularly for overcoming problems. Also, I know some people who find testing their ketone levels just really reassuring. It provide some sort of accountability to the data and they know they're on the right track. Also, if you're like me, you're a bit of a data geek and it can be quite fun to track these things. So if you are testing, then blood ketone readings are by far the most accurate way to check your ketone levels. But whilst the ketone meters themselves are often relatively cheap, the test strips are still quite expensive and we don't want to be wasting them. Testing more often than we need to, or testing at times of day when we're going to be getting a misleading reading. And there are several times during the day when you're going to get falsely low readings. The first time you should avoid testing is first thing in the morning, and that's due to something called the dawn effect. Now, the dawn effect is a normal physiological process that happens to all of us. In the early hours of the morning, there's a surge in a number of hormones, cortisol and adrenaline, and this is part of the body's normal circadian rhythms. It promotes the release of glucose into the bloodstream, which is just there to help you prepare for the day ahead. Now, a lot of diabetics notice a spike in their blood glucose levels at this time of day, but non-diabetics shouldn't actually see a rise because insulin should be compensating for that rise in blood glucose. But that rise in blood glucose will also cause a reactionary lowering of the ketone levels. So if you testing in the early hours of the morning and you find that you've got low ketone levels, it's due to the dawn effect. You want to be waiting at least an hour after you wake up, as a minimum, before you start testing your ketone levels. The second time you should avoid testing is directly after a meal. Even a low carb meal will cause some insulin to be released by the pancreas. So it's not uncommon to see a temporary dip in blood ketone levels at that point. Now, ketones will often quickly recover over the next few hours, but not in an entirely predictable way. And it will vary depending on the meal. Now, as a side note, some people do like to see the response their meals have on their ketone levels and may like to test on a schedule such as before a meal, 30 minutes after that meal, an hour after that meal, or 2 hours after that meal, just to see what their response has been. And this can be quite interesting for a data geek like me to see my body's response to certain meals. But it really doesn't tell us a lot about the long-term stable levels of ketones that our bodies are achieving. So by all means, do it if you're curious, but not really for any other reason than that. Talking of curiosity, I'm curious as to how many people out there are data geeks like I am. So if that is you and you enjoy testing in that way, hit the like button below and type the word geek in the comments just to let me know. Now, the third time of day you should avoid testing is after exercise. Now, ketones are being used by the body for energy, and anything that causes them to be used faster, such as exercise, will cause a temporary lowering of ketone levels that misrepresents your longer term levels. Again, by all means, test for curiosity, but don't get misled when the levels drop after exercise. So that's when we shouldn't be testing, but when should we be testing and how often? Now, I typically recommend the best time of day to test is before your main meals. So lunch and dinner for me. Now, that's typically 12 p.m. and 7 p.m, which fits in with my normal 16-8 pattern of fasting. Checking before lunch gives plenty of time for that dawn effect phenomenon to pass. And typically, I usually work out in the mornings too. Now, if you typically skip breakfast, like a lot of low carbers who do intermittent fasting do, then it'll have been approximately 16 hours since your last meal. If you've not achieved a stable level of ketones by this time, you're probably not in ketosis. And if I had to just test once a day, it would definitely be this before lunch check. And the check before dinner gives plenty of time for you to achieve a stable level of ketones after your lunch, but not if you've just exercised. You may wish to consider testing before bed, for example, if you often work out before your evening meal. And twice a day will give you a good idea if things are stable. Adding in a third testing point, I don't really think it really adds much to your data. So twice a day is what I usually recommend. And if you're going to be testing on a regular basis, you're going to want to find a pattern that works for your particular lifestyle and stick with it. Just make sure you avoid the common mistake times that I've mentioned above. Work out what works for you and stick with it every day. Now, be sure to check out my video where I discuss optimum ketone levels for weight loss. Please don't get caught in that trap of chasing high ketone levels. It doesn't matter anywhere near as much as you might think. You also might find it useful to check my video, which was all about monitoring the symptoms of ketosis to check you're on the right lines. I'll put the links to both of those videos down in the resources section, which you can find in the description of this video. So that's it for today's video. I hope you've enjoyed that. I hope it's been useful for you and hope you've got something out of that. If you've enjoyed this video, please hit the like button down below. And why not leave me a comment in the comment section? So I post new videos every Tuesday. So if you want to receive those videos, subscribe to my channel and you can hit the bell if you want to get notified when those new videos come out. Otherwise, I'll see you next Tuesday. Thanks for watching.